Hello friends, myself Mohit and I am going to dictate you steno legal matter. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for more dictations. So be ready for the dictation. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start.
The petitioners being owners as co-sharers in possession, no offence is made out against them and the prosecution is nothing but malicious and motivated stop. As per the judgment of Honorable the Apex Court rendered in the case of the petitioners falls under categories 2 and 7 of the list of cases laid down as guidelines where the High Court can exercise inherent powers under section 482 CRPC, which reads, thus, where the allegations made in the first information report or the complaint, even if they are taken at their face value and accepted in their entirety, do not prima facie constitute any offense or make out a case against the accused stop, where the allegations in the first information report and other materials, if any, accompanying the FIR do not disclose a cognizable offense justifying an investigation by police officers under section 156 of the code, except under an order of a magistrate within the purview of section 155 of the code stop, where the uncontroverted allegations made in the FIR or complaint and the evidence collected in support of the same do not disclose the commission of any offense and make out a case against the accused stop, where the allegations in the FIR do not constitute a cognizable offense but constitute only a non-cognizable offense, no investigation is permitted by a police officer without an order of a magistrate as contemplated under section 155 of the code stop, where the allegations made in the FIR or complaint are so absurd and inherently improbable on the basis of which no prudent person can ever reach a just conclusion that there is sufficient ground for proceeding against the accused stop, where there is an express legal bar engrafted in any of the provisions of the code or the concerned act under which a criminal proceeding is instituted to the institution and continuance of the proceedings, and or where there is a specific provision in the code or the concerned act providing efficacious redress for the grievance of the aggrieved party stop, where a criminal proceeding is manifestly attended with malafide, and or where the proceeding is maliciously instituted with an ulterior motive for wreaking vengeance on the accused and with a view to spite him due to private and personal grudge stop. The facts narrated above clearly show that the present prosecution is maliciously instituted to grab the property in this manner as the respondent number 2 complainant stop.